Good morning, and a very happy Easter to you all. Welcome to everyone who's joining us for this prayer from wherever you are throughout the world. My name is Ray Warren, an Oblate priest, living and working here in the Dimasnet House Retreat Centre, which is situated in the parish of the English Martyrs, Tower Hill, London. And it's lovely to welcome everyone into this prayer this morning. Let's remember this morning, in particular, all our family members, those who live with us, those who live nearby us, and those who are scattered throughout the world. We keep them especially in mind. And I'd like us particularly to remember families with young children these days, for whom it's a really difficult time, confusing, challenging, and a worrying and exhausting time for parents. We hold them especially in our prayer today. And so we begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord is risen. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Loving and life-giving Father, your Son, the risen Lord, broke the chains of death and renewed the face of the earth with his light and hope. Help each of us in our world, in our pain of confinement, or illness, or isolation, to renew our faith in you and to live in the light of Jesus Christ, your Son, with the Holy Spirit. Amen. The psalm I'd like to read for you today is Psalm 15. Preserve me, God, I take refuge in you. I say to the Lord, you are my God. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. It is you yourself who are my prize. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm. And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad, even my body shall rest in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay. You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right hand, happiness forever. This psalm is very reassuring and comforting. If we think of the time in which it was written, the people in their struggles, and still they were called as people who trusted in God. And so for us in these times, we too might take the psalm or the psalms or a reading of scripture and see when we read them how they speak to us in these moments and at this time. Preserve me, God, I take refuge in you. You are my God. You are my portion and cup. And so I entrust myself to God in spite of whatever is happening in this world at this time. I bless the Lord who gives me counsel. The Lord gives counsel when we give time to listen to the Lord, when we take time out for quiet prayer. That is where we listen and God can speak to us, who even at night directs my heart. So for anyone, parents especially, who are anxious and worried, who often are awake at night worrying for their children or for any situation in their lives, this is a blessing of reassurance, who even at night directs my heart. So I pray that we can be more open in our prayer and in our silence within our struggles and the anxieties of these times, to trust in God, so that our heart will rejoice and our souls be glad, and we can rest in safety. For he will not leave our soul among the dead, nor let us know decay. This is the God who shows us the path of life, and we need to find that path more specifically through these difficult, challenging times, because the fullness of joy is in the presence of God. We are asked to trust in God. And so we pray. Every day I need you, Lord, but this day especially, I need some strength to face whatever is to come. This day, more than any other day, I need to feel you near me to fortify my courage and to overcome my fear. And so, dear Lord, hold my trembling hand. We together pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us and keep us and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Thank you for sharing this prayer with me, and God bless you.